clearly being affected. It was the best performing sector at the start of the session, ended down, whether it was Apple, which has sales in China, or Google and Facebook that don't, they all suffered, but some stood out. Microsoft still ends the day high.
Complete safe haven. Obviously, a crowded, over-owned stock, but it's got everything going for it. And I think what happened was semiconductors were very strong in the rally portion of the day. And then, of course, they're in the crosshairs when you talk about China trade tensions. They reversed. So your haven within tech is Microsoft software, other FANG-like stuff. So I think that was the move. I also think, again, we have to keep in mind, Mexico, when we had the threat of tariffs against Mexico, it seemed like, oh, no, this is another front opening up. And then that just gave the makings of relief down the road if, in fact, it's not as hard a line.
Rufus, how do you expect the Chinese to retaliate or respond?
Well, I don't think the Chinese are going to just immediately fold and do a deal. I mean, you know, this to me signals the trench warfare is getting more serious. I mean, the president tried to soft sell it. I don't know if he was soft selling it to the American consumers or to the Chinese by saying this is just a small tariff increase. But, you know, a 10% tariff, that's sort of five times the level of average U.S. tariffs. It's hard to see this as anything but, you know, a big move and one that has a negative impact for U.S. consumers. Certainly the farmers can't take any comfort in this, that we're closer to a deal. And I don't think the Chinese are going to react positively.
Mohamed El-Erian is able to join us as well on the phone. Mohamed, good afternoon to you. What's your take on the market's reaction to all of this today? What in particular have you been focused on?
I think the market has reacted totally rationally. If you think of what tariffs do, they depress growth around the world, more in the rest of the world than us. Stocks sold off, and the way they sold off was consistent with that. Yields moved a big way down, and that's consistent too, because we're not going to get much inflation out of this. A lot of this is not going to be passed through. Oil went down because global growth prospects are going down, and the dollar hardly moved because in most scenarios the U.S. outperforms, and other central banks will loosen policies much more than the Fed. So I think the market reacted in a very rational way. The move was quite big because it came as a surprise, but it really shouldn't have.
So President Trump is still on the wire. He's making comments, and I'll just share a little bit as it relates to this discussion. President Trump says he can do much more or he can do less on tariffs, depending on what happens with talks with the Chinese. Tariffs on China could be lifted in stages, according to President Trump. And the latest announced tariffs on Chinese imports could be raised to above 25%. Mohamed, the market has dealt with this before. Is it the same playbook, or is this time different because he's venturing into consumer products, which goes right to the heart of the U.S. economy?
You've heard me say that the best you can hope for is a ceasefire. We have to understand that the trade tensions aren't going to go away anytime soon. And they're more likely to escalate than not for two reasons. The drivers are no longer just economic. They now involve national security. And China, which miscalculated in the beginning, now has an incentive to wait this out until the American elections. So the best we can hope for is a ceasefire, but the more likely thing is escalation. Having said that, until now, the markets have focused only on one thing, central bank liquidity. And where the market goes from here is going to be much more a Fed call, ironically, than tariffs, because markets are completely obsessed with the Fed injecting liquidity.
Barbara, are there any of the domestic stocks, some of those smaller caps that stand out to you? Perhaps even the regional banks or not? Zero earnings in China, of course.
Yes, I think anything that doesn't have anything to do with China could be interesting, particularly if it got sold off today. I mean, we could see follow through tomorrow, but I think there's going to be opportunities in those names, in those sorts of names. And I would sniff around in the consumer discretionary retail that has no exposure and find in the regional banks. You know, it's a different story because that's also tied to interest rates and loans and that sort of thing. So, you know, there could be opportunities if they sold off today. Depending.